Happy Halloween!
All right, so we got this little witch here, and that's what we got. We got the witch and the cauldron left to go, and then we can start assembling our piece. I got this this little stick here from my practice stick video that I did on the, that was on the cuts, basic cuts video, five basic cuts. So if you haven't checked that out, be sure and check that out. Basic cuts of five basic cuts of wood carving. But we're gonna knock this little witch out here real quick, and we'll have the cauldron left to go, and we'll be able to quickly assemble. All right, so paint and assemble anyway. So I'm using the bigger flex cut knife here to rough out. I think this is the 2-inch rough out knife. Let's see what she measures. Inch and a half, I'm sorry. Inch and a half rough out. Again, we know we're going to round all this off, so we're going to go ahead and just take these edges off. I always like to take off the edges just to make it comfortable to hold on to, and then we'll draw out where we need to draw out. And get started knocking it out. Again, I learned how to use some time lapse in Adobe Premiere, which is my new video program. So probably time lapse a bunch of this carving, because you can pretty much follow along with the particular cuts when I make. All right, so you can pretty much make the cuts, and I'll time lapse, make it a little faster video since we still got one more to go. So roughly, I gotta have enough to me make a point up here with my hat. So I'm just gonna use my old one as kind of a quick guide. But that's about our piece of wood is actually a 1x4 we're working with. Oh, it's actually 1 5 3/4. And 1 inch wide. 5 3/4 tall by 1 inch wide square. Alright, so we're gonna come down to about 2 inches. 2 inches down, and that's gonna be the bottom of our hat, witch's hat. Alright, and then basically from the hat down to the bottom of the hair, we got an inch. All right, so 2 inches down, 1 inch up. And we're gonna make a stop cut, get our hat started. I'll time lapse it. To speed it up, make it a little quicker. Really like an Adobe Premiere Pro. I just need to learn how to use it pretty good. But it has a lot of features in there. For me, the vocals is usually a problem. So it helps me to be able to correct that and some of the background noise I get. Since I am downstairs, people walking around upstairs. Makes it hard on recording. Especially, like I said before, I got three big German Shepherds up there. And they get a little noisy. I've actually been really noisy today. I've had to stop a couple times, because of somebody outside or a bird or something. Once one of them barks, they all start barking. They don't even sometimes know what they're barking at. They just start barking. Alright, so we've got a stop cut around there. And put a little stop cut right here for the bottom of her hair. And none of these carvings I did have arms. So, you know, if you're wondering where the arms are, they're hidden. You can't see them. And I did that purposely because arms will take a little practice. And we'll do some videos with arms, but for this particular one, I didn't do any arms. Okay, now I want to leave me two little brims here. I got to have a brim for the hat, and then I got to have a little headband or hat band around the hat. So we'll worry about this one first, and then we'll cut this one in after we get down to the meat of the hat there. So basically, I'm just going to start off bigger than what you expect. So we're going to do a little quarter inch, about a quarter of an inch brim. Just roughing it, rough drawing it in. And we're going to do the same thing. We're going to put another stop cut up here at the top. We're going to cut into it this time from the top of the hat, because this is where we're going to be taking away. And then we'll come back and round all that up. A stop cut all the way around, all four corners. And I'm going to put you on time lapse while I knock out this hat. Okay, just so you guys see what happened there. Chipped off that. But I think I saved it. I was gonna have to take those corners off some anyway, since I already had it rounded. I was like, I think I might have enough wood there to save it. So rather than just throw it away and give up, start again, I decided to see if I could save it. I think it's going to be fine. She might have a little bit skinnier hat, but I think all in all it's going to come out fine. Plus, I needed to, I like to have that nose stuck out a little bit more. Okay, so we're going to go down here and we're going to give her a, let's give her a long nose, long witch's nose. Okay, so we're going to go. Let's see. So we're gonna, that might be a little too much. Let's go up about half of that. Just below this line. And we're gonna put a stop cut in there. Here. Remember, go big. Okay. So now we're going to cut the nose. Take our knife, come in, and again, I'm kind of holding the knife at an angle this way. Okay, just leave it there for now. Okay, now we're going to come down with the hair. And the hair is going to come right from the nose down. There. Across the back. And then on the nose. Guys, I'm gonna have to get this back here where I can see a little better. Okay. Don't even make it straight. Just trying to cut it out, to rough it out, so we see where the hair is going. Okay, right there. We got our stop cut right here. Just going to bring that up to the hair. And we'll pretty all this up in a minute. Just want to get it roughed in. Same thing over here. Come down from the tip of the nose, or corner of the nose, I should say. Kind of like if you've carved the Simple Santa, Bob's Simple 5-Minute Santa. Very much like that, only I don't have the arms coming across the body. And that same little design, just with that Simple Santa, you can create so many different types of figures. Maybe we'll do a couple variations of something. But, okay. Just want to get that hair sticking out a little bit so I know where it's at. Stop cut right here on the corner. Take that corner off a little bit right there. I think we're going to save this witch. Even though I chunked off the hat, I think we're going to be all right. This is going to be all rounded. lead hair. Even after my third, this would be my third one, I would have to chip off the hat after telling everybody to take it easy. I'm trying to go fast so I can shorten these videos up a little bit. And that's what happens. I think we're going to be fine. Just going to be fine. Almost there. All right, so we're gonna bring this witch's nose to a point, somewhat of a point. So just take those corners off. I think of a witch, I think of a pointy old nose. Hair back into the hat a little bit so it looks more natural. Gets those corners off of there. Thank you. Just working that nose down to the shape we want to get. Cutting up under that nose. Okay. Grab my detail here. Start cleaning this up a little bit. Okay, so right here, we're going to create a little triangle cut, all right? So we're going to go, let's get this little cleaned up a little bit right there. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to cut in this way towards the nose. Then we're going to cut here towards the hair. And we're going to just come in here like so. And this is going to separate the hair from the nose right there. Now we're just going to blend that in just a little bit. Okay, same thing on this side. We're going to cut in towards the nose. Towards the hair, out from the hair. And up at the top. And we're just going to take that little chip out of there. That in just a little bit. I'm going to take this top of this hat back just a little bit so it's not showing as much on the bottom. We'll fix that a little better when we round it off. Now we're going to finish the hair and around the nose. So you can see, it's kind of hard to see now that it's painted, but the hair is kind of separated from her from the upper body. Alright. And we got a little more shaping of the nose to do. It's kind of a crooked nose, but it is a witch. Alright, so let's take a little bit of this off the side right here. We might have to take our chip cut back in. Thank you. Okay. Shape that nose a little better. Bring that to kind of a point. Even it up on the sides a little bit. Blend the hair. Starting to get there now. Clean off all these roughies. Fuzzies. Alright, now let's separate the hat or the body from the hair again. Back down here. So we can even it up a little bit now that we've taken off. Some of the nose on that side. Take the body down just a little bit. Get a little more round shape right there. So we still kind of had a corner. Okay, we can also take the V tool here. Clean this out. I'm a big fan of the V tools when I can use them. Okay, both sides a little bit. Always kind of got to go back with the knife. Okay, we almost got that. Let's take the hair back down some. Clean this back up. All the way around. This corner's off. give it that flat plane look. Take this little hard edge off right here. This hard edge off here. The more I keep bringing it up under that nose, the more depth I'm getting on the nose. Kind of makes the nose stand out a little better. And takes it up underneath. Let's get the belt on there. This one I'm going to give her a little fatter belt than this one here. So let's go. So we're about right there. And we're going to give her a fat belt on this one. So we just draw a belt line across the top, belt line across the bottom, and then we're going to come in here and make a little box on the center. For a big old buckle. And we'll use those inside lines of the belt. Something like that. Okay. Sometimes it's hard to just leave it alone. All right, so what we're gonna do is We're going to follow that outside outline of the belt. We'll do it with the knife. Get it where you can see it. Here. Come up from the buckle. Across the top of the buckle. Down and over. Same thing on the bottom. Down. Outside line of the buckle. Outside line of the belt. Alright. So we'll start right here at the top of the belt. Now we gotta really be careful we don't chip this one. So we're gonna do little tiny cuts first. And we don't have to go very deep. We just want that to stand up a little bit. We'll do that too by taking this back. We'll help. Okay, now we need to take a little chip out right there. So I'm gonna cut that again. Cut that again. And we're gonna come right inside. Real easy. Take that little chip out. Okay. Same thing on this side. Come in. Back up my line. Cut this one more time. Easy. Take that little chip out and then cut this down in. All right. So basically, we'll repeat the same thing at the bottom. Come down here. Here, up to my line. Take that little chip out. Okay. Come across the bottom of the buckle. One more time. Easy cut up to it. We're almost just doing little triangle cuts right in here just to get that little chip out of there. Let's blend this back in. Okay. on some. Like I said on the before when I was talking about the, don't be afraid to cut it deeper, because when you're going to go back and round these sharp edges off, it's going to bring it back down. Okay, last little corner here, down, over. Take that little chip out. There goes the dogs. Alright, so before we round that off, we're going to blend this in a little bit. And then we'll come back and put a little, few little three-dimensional cuts in to give its depth back. Always look at your piece from different angles. Look at it close up. Look at it far away. And that'll help you. And you'll see things that you don't see from your carving angle a lot of times. Okay, so we want that belt to look like it's going back under there. Same thing what we did over here. We're going to do a little triangle cut, a little chip cut. Okay, same thing right here. cut it a little lower right here where it goes under. All right, same thing on the other side where the belt goes into the hair. A little chip cut right there. And then right here, same thing. This almost makes her look like she's got a skinny, skinny waist. Or that the belt is tightened around her waist, I should say. Okay, we're almost done with her. We got a couple more things. We got to put a band around the hat. We got to take these hard edges off right here. Now, right here where the belt buckle goes, put a line, little, don't go too deep. A little cut right there. And take that belt down just a hair. We got the belt buckle standing now. Same thing on this side of the belt buckle. Little cut, not too deep. Little stop cut right up to it. Let's take off the hard edges. If it ain't the dogs, it's the old rooster outside. Just want to take that edge a little bit so it's not a hard edge. And then I'll take that corner just a little bit in. Just cut that tip off of that corner of the belt. Alright. Now we're going to do the same thing on the inside of the belt. So we're going to do a little cut, not too deep. The width of the belt. Come across. This is where you really get into your detailing. And I know some of the small detail will be hard to see on camera. I don't want that belt and the buckle underneath the buckle to just sit down in there a little bit. Let's take off these pencil lines. Be real careful because there's a spot that's about to want to chip off right there. Sometimes it's just better to leave it alone if you start getting a bad spot that wants to come off. Okay. There's our buckle. Once I paint it, you'll be able to see it a little better, like here. Alright, blend this up into the buckle. Right here, we're almost done with this. We got the hat, and the witch will be done. No detailing, though. We still got to do some detailing on it, on her hair. That only takes a couple seconds. Let me know out there if you're already carving. Let me know in the comments. Do you have a hard time quitting on a piece and saying enough's enough? Like me. Thought I got myself for a minute there. But yeah, let me know in the comments. That's a problem for you too. This piece, I have to cut one way, otherwise it wants to chip. So I gotta go up this way all the time. Say enough's enough. Okay, enough's enough. Nose looks good, hair blending in. Alright, let's finish the hat. So the same thing we did on the belt. We're going to give her a big old wide hat band. Only this time, we don't have to go two sides. Okay, had a little camera problem there, but we're going to give her a wider band on her witch's hat here. So we just went around, drew that band where we wanted it. All right, we're going to do the same thing we're going to do that we did right here. So we're gonna put a little buckle, because on the other one I didn't put a buckle. So basically draw a little square. We'll just have the buckle hidden by the top of the hat. Alright, So we're going to take and hit our detail knife here. And we're just going to start. And it doesn't even have to be perfect. Everybody, just remember that your lines, they don't have to be perfect. All right, I'm going to cut around. All the way around the hat. We're going to leave the buckle alone for a second. Just come all the way around. Make our band meet back here. Alright. And then we're just going to get this notched out a little bit with stop cut. Just want that raised up just a little bit. We're just going to continue making our stop cuts all the way around up to the buckle. And right here at the buckle, we're going to come up like we did on the belt. Just come up. Go ahead and do both sides. A little stop cut. Basically, I'm just going to get these pencil lines off. Okay, go the other side. Actually, we'll start over here and we'll work our way around to the buckle again. Up to the buckle. We can go back and make it a little deeper if we want it to stand out a little more. Down. Okay, so there we go. We got the band in there. We're almost done with the switch. Alright, so we want the buckle to sit a little higher. So we're going to come up on each side of the buckle. Then we're going to cut a little stop cut in towards the buckle. Make that band look like it's going up in the buckle. Don't want to get it too deep right there. You don't want it to disappear. It's a little stop cut. Chip it out. Okay, let's take the pencil lines off. Take a little bit of the edges off. A little detail on that corner. Let's take that little tip of that corner off of there. All right. Now, we're going to come inside the buckle just a little bit. And we're going to open it up a little bit right here. Just take a little chip cut out of that buckle. This little detail I know is probably hard to see on the camera. But You guys will see yours a little better. You can see it. And you'll see it better when we paint it too. Okay. So we got a little box inside the buckle. The rest of these pencil marks off. Smooth your edges down a little bit. Take that sharp edge off the band. Make it look uniform. Down. There we go. So we got our witch's hat just about done. All right, so we're gonna round this off a little bit. Just take these hard edges off. Round the hat. Rest these pencil marks off. Yeah, I think we saved the hat. Fuzzy right there. Get that guy out of there. Alright, so all we got left to do is put a little texture in the hair. So we're just going to take our V-tool, and we're going to come down here first and put some little notches on the bottom. Take our V tool. I'm just gonna start putting some texture in her hair. Just randomly pop around. Some short ones and some long ones. Be careful you don't chip, get going too hard and take a chip out of your hat. Change directions a little bit, make it a little bit of an angle going up under the hat. It's like so. Make sure you get on the side right here by the nose. I think that does it for the witch. Got our witch all done. All we got left is our cauldron. Here's our first witch. Here's our second witch. And next we're going to do the cauldron, which should be pretty quick. It's just a round pot, basically. We'll put a little hump in here for the witch's brew, and a couple little handles on it, and we'll be ready to start painting and assembling. Okay, we're going to finish up with the cauldron, and so what we're using here, this block is an inch and 3/4. Actually, it's inch and a half by two. Inch and a half by two. All right, so we're gonna come down. We wanna leave a little bit of a lip on this thing. So we're gonna start off with about a quarter of an inch. So we're gonna come down about a quarter of an inch. And we'll go a little bit plus that, just so we can take off a little more of the top. Okay, so we could go around there. Got 3/8. 3/8. Okay. So on this, we're just going to start rounding this. Come on, take off all of our corners. With stop cuts. And I'll probably time lapse this when I start chucking away on it, just to cut down on the video time a little bit. But you guys know the rules by now. Just take off your corners, make it comfortable. This was just a little scrap block that I found. This whole project's been created out of scrap. Okay. So, stop cuts, and we'll take this off, and then I'll bring you back. stay right here with this, but we're gonna start taking it in. So we need to round this top part just a little bit and start kind of taking it over, and we're gonna, we won't take the top completely off. We'll fix that when we get to it. Okay, so this is pretty much gonna be round as well. So we're gonna go ahead and take the corners off of that. Now we're going to cut a V cut on both sides. So we're going to go here and here. Now that we kind of got it working our way around, I'm just going to cut some V cuts. Start making that little brim on the pot. Bring this bottom down a little more. Let's make this a little deeper. So this way it makes the top stick out a little more. gonna take and fix this little spot here. Or don't look a little flat. Okay. Take that hard edge off. Now we're going to take and make a circle, leave a rim for the pot. So we want to kind of come in around, leave an equal border, about an eighth of an inch in, depending on what you want. Fix that a little better right there. Okay. Don't have to be perfect. Take a little V tool. If you have one, if not, use your big V tool. And take that pencil line out of there. Okay, we just want to get a starting point here. To get down in there. All right, now we're going to take our knife. Cut down in there. Using the tip, follow your V cut. And we're on the end grain, so it's going to be a little tougher. Alright. Now, we're going to go in and get this out of here. Okay. And we're going to come on the outside of the rim and come back through it again. Got a little rough spot right there. Don't want to come out. Clean that up. right, now we're going to come back and round this over and just clean that top of that rough stuff off of there a little bit. If you have to, just make it deeper. And you can kind of round that a little bit right there on the inside of the pot, the witch's brew. Just enough to clean that rough stuff off of there. Tough spot right there. I think we got it. Okay, so just clean all that. Saw cuts off of there. So if you got some fuzzies, you can take your bigger V tool now and just kind of clean that out. Don't worry too much on that top part. It's gonna might look a little rough anyway, but you're gonna paint it and it'll look fine. Okay. So there's our pot. Need a couple handles. All right, so all I did on the handles was I just drew crossed and made like a U here just to give me some kind of idea. Go on the other side right here, same thing, make a U. Try to get them look the same. This one's a little small. Okay. Then take your knife. Stop cut. Follow your lines. Want that handle raised up a little bit. Okay. Let's get the other side, then we'll come back and fix it, finish it, come down. Okay, now we're going to go inside that same piece and do the same draw, same type of work, just smaller on the inside of that handle. Just a little U shape and a straight line. Straight line and a U shape. And on the inside, we're just going to make a little triangle cut. Just a little chip cut out of there. Same thing on the other side. Straight line. And chip cut. Clean all the pencil lines off so you can see it. just a little more. Try to get it looking the same. Both sides. I always like to take those little tip corners off of there. Just makes it. Dimensionally, it makes it look better. I got a real fuzzy piece right here on this end. The sides. Okay. Same thing on the other side. Get the pencil marks off. Biggest challenge will be getting it without taking too much away. But you can always go back in here and make this a little deeper. Those corners off. Okay, there's our cauldron. This one looks like it might be a little fatter, so I'm gonna come back here and take a little bit of this off. Okay, little different, little fatter here at the top than this one, but that's okay. Once we get it painted with our witch, that's what we'll have. All right, guys, that concludes it. We've got all of our pieces now. We've got the witch, we got the ghost, we got the two bats, we got the broom. We got the cauldron. We got our three tombstones. We've got our fresh grave. And we got our mummy. So, I think we'll do a quick paint video on all these because they're pretty simple paint jobs. And put them all in place and wrap this thing up. Alright, guys. Thanks for watching. If you haven't already, make sure you subscribe. Please like and subscribe and give me some comments. Let me know what you think. If you're watching these videos all the way to the end, I hope you are. Just give me a comment. Give me a like. Give me some constructive criticism on what you think about the videos. Comments will help. And share this out to your friends in the carving community. And we'll be back with the painting video. Thanks for watching.